Hi everyone, and thanks for watching News to Go. We've got sunshine and mild temperatures early on for this Monday. I'd call them fair skies. Early temperatures have been in the low 70s, but we warm up so quickly around here. Our lunchtime temperature will leap into the mid 80s for northwest Arkansas, and later the high will top out at 90. It will be breezy through the afternoon and well into the evening, and also a little more humid as we move through the late day and certainly into tomorrow. River Valley, partly cloudy to fair skies early on. Lunchtime temperature, really warm in the upper 80s. Later today, your high will be 94. It's not record breaking, but you're a little on the toasty side. A few high clouds and windy throughout the day. Una?
Laura, thank you. Well, Alan Crawford is expected in court this morning after threatening a man in June, but the legal issues are not over for the Mulder man. 4D29's Megan Key tells us about today's arraignment.
Alan Crawford is expected to have his arraignment hearing today after he allegedly threatened to kill a car salesman in Sebastian County last month. Once his appearance is finished, he and his wife will appear in a Washington County courtroom later this month. This is video of Crawford entering a Washington County courtroom. At today's arraignment here at the River Valley, the judge will discuss bond and he's expected to enter a plea. According to his Sebastian County arrest report, Crawford is facing a terroristic threatening charge, which is a first-degree felony. He and his wife, Daphne Crawford, are scheduled for an arraignment on July 22nd. For terroristic threatening after allegedly threatening a waitress in a Prairie Grove diner last month. Alan was also arrested for fleeing. Alan Crawford's arraignment will begin at 12:30 here at the Sebastian County Courthouse in Greenwood. In Greenwood, Megan Key, 4D29 News.
Well, Megan, thank you. And both Alan and Daphne Crawford are being held in the Washington County Detention Center. And this morning, the family of a missing man says that they have no updates on his location. Fort Smith police say Philip Smith disappeared last Wednesday and they believe he may be in danger. This picture was taken Friday morning. His truck found abandoned at Spring Hill Park in Barling. If you have any information, you are asked to call police. And this morning, police are asking for your help identifying two suspects. Fayetteville police say these two people allegedly stole more than $600 from vending machines in the city. If you know of who they are or have any other information, you could call the Fayetteville Police Department or contact them on Facebook. Thank you so much for watching News to Go. Have a wonderful Monday, everyone.